That was easy.
That was quick. Not bad.
That was a test. I barely broke a sweat.
Hey, don't get cocky, Hotshot. That was just a primer. As you'd guess, delivering messages will take you through areas swarming with infected. And sometimes, at night. For this test, you'll need to pick up 5 letters that were dropped in a dark zone when the previous carrier was being chased by the infected. You'll need real skills just to survive, let alone succeed. Piece of cake for a pilgrim, though, right?
Yep. This sounds more my speed. I'll see you soon.
Whew. Discovered a new location that's supposed to be filled with well-preserved books. Stop by when you can.
Thank you.
Not bad, Hotshot. Not bad.
That hardly qualified as a test.
Ha! This last one, mate. You come face to face with customers. This is what the job is about. Connecting people through the letters they send and receive. Reconnecting our fractured society, so to speak. This is where you prove your true worth.
I can handle it. Believe it or not, I'm sort of a people person.
Oh, you could have fooled me. But I have to admit, you're not a fragile type. I'm starting to see some potential. Pull this off, and I might consider letting you take the carrier's oath after all. I just better not get any complaints from the clients.
You won't. I promise.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
Hello, I'm from the Carrier's Guild. I have a letter for Barry.
Mom? Mommy! It's a letter from Dad!
Careful! Don't tear the letter when you open it.
I won't, Mom. I swear.
Bless you, Carrier. You made my son's day.
Having the power back on will change the tide of the war. I hear the PK engineers are working on alarms and electric traps.
I have a letter for you.
Finally.
I'm sorry, sir. I brought the letter as soon as it was given to me.
I'm not upset with you. It's my son. Weeks without hearing from him. Thought he was dead. No concern for his father. I'm thankful for you, Carrier. At least now I know my idiot son is still alive.
Chances against renegades were pretty good. But now...
I have to say, Aiden, I haven't seen Albert this happy in forever. Thank you for what you're doing. Here's a list for your next book search. I've enjoyed our talks. But I tend to hog the conversation. Are there any questions you'd like to ask me?
Well, actually, I am curious about something.
Wonderful. What would you like to know?
I get that you're a romantic, but are you into subjects like science?
An interesting question. Hopefully my answer will be worthy of it. You ask, though, as if they are entirely different ends of the spectrum. But to me, they are parallel notions. Whether it's science or romance, answers to questions are often best guesses based on what can be observed. With a different perspective, the same information leads to a different answer. For example, the sun was once a fiery god that, with better observational tools, was revealed to be but a fiery ball of gas. How do you feel about science? Especially given its role in our current mess.
Science is just a tool, like a hammer. You can use it to build the shelter or bury it in someone's skull.
A vivid but effective example. Hopefully we'll see more shelters and fewer of the other. Hurry back so we can speak some more.
Of course. I'm looking forward to it.
Flaunting the PK's authority and you'll be whipped. Am I making myself clear? Catch you stealing, you lose a hand, pal. No order without strict laws.
This, my friend, is an angle grinder.
My dad had one like that in his workshop. Same brand, even.
An amazing thing.
Fire in the hole, not a value.
That's a corundum grinder. You know what that is, kid?
Thank you. Inhibitor container detected.
heli supply doing? Delivering lamps ain't a difficult job.
Bother me. I'm thinking.
Well, then at least you know what you're thinking.
What others fuck up royally, we do with our eyes shut.
I'm innocent.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
If I have the briefing, get your asses in gear and trip.
Hey, you. Want to be sent back to me?
You'll see.
Imagine.
Freaks me out when things like that
happen.
Well, thing is, that was me.
Shit, that's right. Sorry.
Ah, you're a miracle worker. You found them and brought them back safely. Oh, here now is one of the original great American novels. The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. Mark Twain was a wry observer of the human condition and a sharp-witted satirist. What would his take on the divisions of our society be, I wonder? Here we have what is known as the Written Torah, an introduction, if you will, to the origin story of the Jewish people, and part of the larger concept of the Torah that includes all their teachings, culture, and practice. A crucial tome of religion and culture. Our collection is growing by leaps and bounds. Primarily due to your leaping and bounding. Nothing? You are a stoic, aren't you? Damn. Thought you'd have a better sense of humor than Thalia. Oh, well.
Aiden, it's such a wonderful day. Let's dispense with all this dreary philosophizing, shall we?
Okay.
I see you brought back the Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. Tell me, Aiden, as a pilgrim, are you an adventurer like Huckleberry Finn?
Every day out there was an adventure, I can tell you that. Not always a pleasant one, though.
There was plenty of unpleasantness in Huckleberry Finn.
In that case, call me Huck.
And I'll be your Mary Jane. Tell me, Aiden, do you have a thing for older women like Huck did?
Excuse me?
Never mind. I am just glad you've retained your sense of humor in the face of this world's darkness. And don't ever think I take for granted the danger you surely encounter every day.
The danger's out there, Thalia. Here with you. No reason not to relax.
That's how I feel when you're around, Aiden. Thank you for that. I'll anxiously await your return. Before you go,